Hey guys, it's Alicia, and today I'm going to show you how to fix the "another update is currently in progress" error in WordPress. Are you getting a strange error on your updates page preventing you from upgrading WordPress core or even your theme and plugins? Sometimes this problem will sort itself out, but if you've waited a long time and you're still stuck on this message, it's not likely to resolve on its own. In this video, we will go over why this problem happens and a few suggested ways to get your site working again. Before we get too far, of course, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. All right, now let's look at what causes the update in progress error. When your site is working as intended, going to the dashboard, then updates screen will show your current version of WordPress. You can also initiate an update for WordPress core, your theme, or your plugins. But if your site has updated recently, you may notice a brief message has taken over or appears when you attempt to update or reinstall anything. Another update is currently in progress. This removes all the update buttons and prevents you from doing anything else on the page. If you know that you just ran an update, this is actually intended functionality to keep you from accidentally breaking your site while an update is downloading. If you didn't start the update yourself, it may have been caused by the auto update function, or another user on your site with high level privileges could have initiated the update process. While it's normal to see this screen while an update is running, it's not normal for it to stay there for hours on end. WordPress does intentionally lock your database, but sometimes the lock doesn't get removed properly. Maybe the update didn't finish properly due to a server connection blip or something else that went wrong, but you could get stuck on the update in progress screen indefinitely. It's normal to see the update in progress message for about 15 minutes after an update is initiated, so don't jump to messing with your database too quickly. But if you've waited some time and are still seeing the error, it's probably time to take further measures into your own hands. Wait at least an hour since you first noticed the message, then try out one of these steps. Always remember to back up your database and your site as a whole before editing backend files, especially if you aren't familiar with the process. Usually, fixing this problem requires digging through your database or getting accustomed to advanced developer tools like WP-CLI. But if you don't want to risk breaking anything, there's a much simpler option available. The fix another update in progress does exactly what it indicates on the tin. While it's an older plugin that hasn't been updated in a long time, recent reviews indicate that it still works just fine, and its 10,000 plus active installations attest to that. There are also not many other alternatives available, so this is the best option in the WordPress repository. But it doesn't appear to be supported by the developer anymore, so use it at your own risk. To install it, log in and go to Plugins, then Add New. Search for Fix Another Update in Progress and click to install the plugin. You can also download the plugin manually and click Upload Plugin on this page. Once you activate it, you'll see a new menu under Settings labeled Fix Another Update in Progress. If it detects the lock in your database, it will show this screen. Just click the Fix WordPress Update Lock button and the database entry should be instantly removed. After that, you're good to go and your updates page should be usable again. It's not a good idea to leave unused plugins on your site, so you can go ahead and uninstall it if you don't see this issue cropping up again. If you've never delved into your database before, this solution is a fairly easy and safe one as long as you don't touch any sensitive settings. Just make sure to run a backup before touching anything in your database and only delete the one broken row. First, you should log into PhpMyAdmin. Kinsta users can open MyKinsta and access PhpMyAdmin through its interface. If you're using a different host, you can usually access it through cPanel. On the left menu, with several dropdowns, open your site's database and select WP Options. Once you click through the WP Options, you should see a table of various database entries. You may see it right in the list, or your table may be far too large. If you can't find it, use the filter rows bar above the table and enter Core Updater Lock to jump right to it. Now just click Delete on the Core Updater Lock row. With that, you're free to go back to WordPress and update your site again. If messing with your sensitive database feels a bit too uncomfortable, or all those tables make you feel overwhelmed, there's a quick and easy solution, WP-CLI. This is the WordPress command line interface, a way to interact with your database or other aspects of your site without needing to manually navigate through cPanel and PhpMyAdmin. Enter one line of code and your problem is instantly solved. Many WordPress hosts these days, including Kinsta, already come with WP-CLI installed, so you don't need to do any difficult setup. As with editing your database directly, you should still back up your site before running the command line. Check out how to connect to SSH for some extra guidance. But here are the basics. Windows users will need to install a program like PuTTY, while Mac and Linux users already have a terminal built in. You'll also need to get your SSH credentials from your host. You may be able to find this in cPanel under SSH access, or Kinsta users can find it under the Info tab in My Kinsta. Windows users should install PuTTY and enter the hostname /IP, port, username, and password provided by your host. Mac and Linux users can just open the terminal and enter this command. Enter your password if prompted. Now, whether you're using PuTTY on Windows or the terminal on Mac or Linux, you should be able to enter commands in your server. Type in the following. Getting there is a little difficult, but with just one command, your problems are over. And remember, if none of these steps work or you're just not comfortable trying to fix it on your own, you can always contact your host and ask for their assistance. Looking for a quality local development solution? With DevKinsta, in a single click, you can design, develop, and deploy new WordPress projects from your local machine. Plus, it's 100% free to use, even if you aren't a Kinsta customer. Download it today at kinsta.com/devkinsta. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.